Welcome to Success Talks with Rodney Saulsberry. I hope you will support my sponsors who bring you this podcast absolutely free and with limited interruptions. I really appreciate you taking the time to listen. I'll get started in just a second.
The reviews are in. The latest book from voiceover superstar and coach Rodney Saulsberry is another runaway hit. Readers from all over the world are raving about his newest title, Tongue Twisters and Vocal Warm-Ups. You can find this and his other titles at the top of the voiceover bestsellers list on Amazon.com.
Prince Rogers Nelson was born in Minneapolis, Minnesota, to Maddie Shaw, a jazz singer and social worker, and John L. Nelson, a lyricist and pianist. His father's stage name was Prince Rogers. His parents were both from African-American families from Louisiana. They separated during his youth, which led him to move back and forth. Prince had a troubled relationship with his stepfather, which led him to run away from home. Prince was adopted by a family called the Andersons. Prince, at the age of 18, started working on high-quality demo tracks with Chris Moon. With these demo tracks, Prince eventually ended up signing a recording contract with Warner Brothers Records and was the youngest producer associated with the label.
And we'll be back after this message.
Hello, everyone. This is Sean Daly for DailyVO.com. I want to tell you about one resource I highly recommend for vocal warm-ups because it takes out all of the guesswork and it was purpose-built with voiceover in mind. It's called Rodney Saulsberry's Tongue Twisters and Vocal Warm-Ups with Other Vocal Care Tips. How's that for a title? So in case you don't know, Rodney Saulsberry is a top-tier talent and coach, motivational speaker, and author of several books on voice acting, including You Can Bank on Your Voice and Step Up to the Mic. The book is available in print and on Kindle, and you can find it at Amazon or Rodney's personal website, rodneysaulsberry.com, in the store section.
Prince made his debut on the record label with his 1978 album, For You. It wasn't a strong, successful album. However, it was fair for a beginning artist and ranked 163 on the U.S. pop charts. Prince's next releases would tend to do much better on the charts with his singles Why You Wanna Treat Me So Bad and I Wanna Be Your Lover in 1979. When Prince released his single 1999, that is the single that truly put him on the map. This single began to be noticed by MTV audiences, and this would make him a part of the mainstream music media. Prince released two more singles called Little Red Corvette and Delirious. The album featured Prince's new band, The Revolution. In 1984, Prince would release what would be seen as an admired and profound masterpiece, the feature film soundtrack album, Purple Rain. Prince's father contributed to this album by co-writing the chord sequences for a couple of his songs. Prince continued to give co-writing credit to his father on several other albums, as his famous chord sequence would be used in several of Prince's singles and albums.
And we'll be back after this message.
Has anyone ever said to you that you have a nice voice and you should get into voiceovers? Well, this is your chance to find out how to do that online in Rodney Saulsberry's voiceover online seminar for beginners only. You can find out what it takes to be a voiceover artist. And here's the beauty of this online seminar. You don't have to be there. When you register, you will automatically get a copy of the seminar. Go to my website at rodneysaulsberry.com and sign up today.
In 1991, Prince assembled a new band called the New Power Generation. With this band, he would release singles such as Diamond and Pearls, Cream, and Get Off. Prince eventually changed his stage name from Prince to a symbol, which led people to call him the artist formerly known as Prince. Soon after that, Prince eventually took back his old stage name, Prince. Prince was one of the greatest entertainers of all time, and the thing about him is that he played every instrument on his albums. In the 1990s, Prince continued to release singles such as Came, The Gold Experience, Chaos and Disorder, and Emancipation. With the rise of the new millennium, Prince released material such as a religious album called The Rainbow Children, One Night Alone, The Chocolate Invasion, The Slaughterhouse, and he had a collaboration with the great Stevie Wonder on Stevie's single called The Fuss. in 2005.
Are you looking for expert advice on advancing your voiceover career? Are you just getting started in the business? Join the Consultants Club and receive monthly coaching on how to read scripts, interpret copy, and get work in the fastest growing business in the world. When you join the Consultants Club, go to RodneySalisbury.com and sign up today.
Unfortunately, Prince died on April 21st, 2016, in Chanhassen, Minnesota, at his Paisley Park recording studio complex. He was 57 years old. Prince will be remembered as a musician and artist who inspired millions through his music and set an inspirational platform which others still abide by. And we here at Success Talks are proud to celebrate the outstanding career of Prince.
You can listen to any of Rodney's podcasts at any time. Go to RodneySalisbury.com.
I hope you enjoyed this podcast, and I urge you to listen to future podcasts where I will continue to try and make you better than before. My goal is to point you in a positive direction to success right here on Success Talks with me, Rodney Saulsberry.